Jake is so funny. He kept stealing Aiden's Christmas presents and pretending to help him open them, and then he would store them in his cupboard and keep him safe and sound.
I have to say, this is the first Christmas that Emma really was able to appreciate it.
Yeah, I'm not even going to pretend to be objective. Her face was amazing.
Immortalized by all the thousands of pictures you took of her.
Aww. Memories.
There's nothing better than experiencing the holidays with your kids. Speaking of, does anybody have plans for New Year's Eve?
Actually, I decided to invite Patrick to stay until New Year's. We're going to give this trial togetherness thing a whirl.
Hey, where's Cam?
He's in daycare. He is so excited he refuses to take off those snow boots we bought him.
Is that why that bus is out there? You're going on a little hospital ski trip?
Yes, obviously. I couldn't get away, so my lovely brother has offered to take Cam.
Any chance to get on the mountain a couple of days? It's going to be great teaching Cam how to ski.
Oh, my goodness. What my brother is nobly not saying is that the majority of the people going are teenagers. It's going to be a very long trip.
Dr. Niles in yet?
I can page her if you'd like.
No. He's the opposite. If she asks for a consult, I'm not available.
So, you're gonna teach Cam how to ski?
Oh, I'm sure gonna try.
Remember, that boy's a Weber. He picks things up fast.
Our dad had us on skis since we were four.
Cameron has a lot of time to make up for then.
The idea of Emma on skis just scares me.
Honey, it's inevitable.
I suppose. At least she'll have her daddy to pick her up when she falls.
That's right.
Tell me Matt is not with a patient.
How dare people get ill and mess up your plans?
The ski trip was his idea, not mine.
I didn't know you were going on the ski trip.
With my brother.
I happen to love skiing. Happen to love a glass of wine by the fire at the lodge even more.
Well, Cedar Mountain has some pretty challenging runs.
Oh, I'm counting on it so I can press Max with my double down skills.
Well, maybe you will be the one to be dazzled.
Yeah, I'm counting on it.
Kate, the specs for the April issue. Thank you, Lulu. That's perfect. No, I'm still waiting for Matt. I swear, if he cancels on me for brain surgery, I'm gonna kill him. I'll talk to you later, bye.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. I promised Matt that I would help him house hunt, and here I am going on this ski trip when clearly Matt hates living in that month-to-month rental, so I'm pretty selfish.
No, I was surprised to hear that you're going on the ski trip with Matt, but I want you to have fun. Okay? And if at any point you feel like you want to sabotage your trip, please call me and I'll talk you down.
Deal. I love you. I love you too.
All right, you have my patient files. Thank you for taking them.
Not a problem. I just hope it's worth it.
Well, you tell me. You're the expert on high maintenance women.
It's worth it, for sure.
You and Robin seem like you're in a better place.
We're taking it slow, but yeah, I feel like we're moving in the right direction. She needs to believe that she can trust me again. And I have to earn that trust, so.
Hey, Patrick, did you get that chart that I left?
Yeah, I already looked at it.
Oh, great. Well, if you want, we can go over the post-diagnostic in the cafeteria and grab a snack.
Actually, I think it's better that we do it here. Less chance of a distraction.
You know, we all know how easily you get distracted, Dr. Niles.
It's an easy drive to...
It's only going
to
be a couple of days, but I already miss Cameron. He walked out of here like such a big boy.
And he'll come back ready for the Olympics.
I know how you feel. When I went to Africa, I missed Emma so much. I mean, I knew that you were taking care of her, but no matter how hard I tried to justify it, I was still gone for my little girl. Oh, I have a patient waiting.
It's all right. We're working through it. One step at a time.